Titans is on the move. These beasts are called Stegosaurus, which means roof lizard. They are 7-ton Jurassic Titans. Despite weighing almost 7 tons, these creatures, they come from little animals that are no less than 20 pounds. We are on the opposite side of the island, away from Dylan, Sally, or Mark. And these 7-ton Stegosaurus are on the move. But today we will not be following Mark, Dylan, or Sally. We will be following a young Stegosaurus named Chris. Today we shall be following this group of Stegosaurus for almost 2 days as they go from one side of the island to the other in the Titan's Trek. Several Compsognathus are awaiting for the Stegosaurus. The small 20-pound Compsognathus cannot take on the 7-ton bull Stegosaurus to guard the herd, so they want the babies. The infant Stegosaurus are still frightened by this, but luckily they have the larger juvenile Stegosaurus to protect them still. There are 3 main Stegosaurus that belong to Chris's herd. This is the leader of the herd. He is a 40-year-old old bull Stegosaurus named Bullseye. He weighs almost 8 tons and is an experienced fighter. On the other hand, there are the 2 late Jurassic juvenile delinquents of the herd, Chris on the left and Kate on the right. Chris is a young 1-year-old Stegosaurus and Kate is about his same age. Chris and Kate never learn and they regularly stray away from the herd. Comes across other dinosaur activity. A small herd of Triceratops has stopped from their long trek to feast. Triceratops are normally docile animals, but they can be extremely dangerous if provoked, and predators normally do not attack them. But unfortunately for all the other animals here, there is one predator magnet, a young Diplodocus. Young Diplodocus are extremely targeted animals. Despite being so large, they're not big enough to repel attack from an adult Tyrannosaurus, or even an adult Spinosaurus. And that's what makes them good targets. This young one could actually be almost 50 feet long. Some predators are wild enough to even take on these miniature titans. An Allosaurus. 150 million years ago, this small Diplodocus would be easy food for an Allosaurus. Though in 150 million years of evolution, Allosauruses have dwarfed to now only 20 feet long. Diplodocus, on the other hand, has not changed one bit. But sometimes evolution picks favorites. Instead of dwarfing, this predator became supersized. Carnotaurus. All he had to do is knock the Diplodocus down, and it's broken its back. Within 75 million years, Carnotaurus has gotten to be almost 30 feet long and 20 feet tall. It has been almost 3 days now. The Stegosaurus herd is plowing throughout the desert. They could pass through the dense foliage around them on the desert's edges, but that's too thick for them. And being 30 feet long each, they'll get stuck. Bullseye, the lead Stegosaurus, is also starting to become delusional. He is very tired and suffering of heat stroke. Pteranodon are starting to circle around, waiting for one of them to drop. Chris, too, is tired and delusional. He hasn't drunk any water in almost a week, and he is dying. Chris and Kate are falling behind the rest of the herd. The adults feel something. The winds pick up and a sandstorm starts. Sandstorm is ravaging the sides of this small cliff, but the Stegosaurus has finally reached their destination. Sally the Utah Raptor is here to witness the arrival of all the Stegosaurus. At long last, after almost 4 days, the Stegosaurus finally reached this side of the island, along with Sally, Mark, and Bill. Chris and Kate climbed down from the cliffs they were on and have now come to the bottom of the basin. These young Stegosaurus are always doing stuff that they shouldn't. Chris smells something that he normally does not smell. Chris and Kate know what this is, and they are afraid. They know that a mother Daspletosaurus cannot be far, and unfortunately, they're right. This is a full-grown female Daspletosaurus. Normally, she would not dare attack an animal like Chris, but if her baby's in trouble, then she'll do anything to protect it. They are saved by the huge spiked tail of a 7-ton male Stegosaurus, Bullseye. Chris and Kate live to fight another day.